Hello everyone, my name is Anand Raj. I'm a PLM on the Network Services platform, and I'm going to show you an IP MPLS optimization application on the NSP platform. So the NSP IP MPLS optimization application is an SDN controller, and the main thing I'm showing you today is how it computes inter-domain paths. The SDN controller, as you can see here, provides end-to-end visibility into all the domains it discovers. So one of the challenges in provisioning paths across multiple domains is the fact that you have a lack of inter-domain coordination. So as reachable prefixes are not advertised in multiple domains. We satisfy this, or we solve this problem by discovering these prefixes that requires domains not to re-advertise prefixes. And so the control plane information is contained to these domains, and we compute a path end-to-end. The other challenge also is when you use technologies such as segment routing, if you're computing paths that are inter-domain, then you run into the segment routing problem, which is the maximum sit depth problem. So what we are showing here are two applications. There are two ways to solve this. One is taking advantage of something called the anycast sits. So if you have domain ASBRs, routers between instance 1 and instance 0, and instance 0 and instance 2, for example, that's showing multiple domains there, if you have anycast sit representations on the ASBR routers, then we on the NSP side will be able to provision a segment routing error only using anycast. And as the anycast sits, if the anycast sits are not available, we fall back to the loose hop. So option one here specifies loose hop anycast ASBRs. This means that my ERO segmentation would be the start router or the start anycast sits for this particular example and the destination, or the destination anycast sits here between the destination domain and the intermediate domain. And the second example, where we specify loose hop ASBRs, where instead of specifying any cast sit, we simply specify the ERO of the best node set to transit the domain. Mind you, also, we have failover options. In the case where any cast isn't available, or if any cast isn't available because of failure, we resort back to the loose hop ASBRs. So I'll quickly show you on my IP MPLS optimization application. So this is my IP MPLS optimization application. As you can see, I've discovered multiple domains here. These domains are represented by three different colors. There's the yellow color for domain 10, there's the purple for domain 20, and domain 30. And I've got a few LSPs up and running that take advantage of the inter-domain routing. So the first LSP that I'm simply going to highlight here is this LSP here, which starts from Vegas, which is represented by node router ID 219, and terminates in Detroit. And if I simply go and overlay this LSP, you can see that I've got a source router here, my destination router here, and these two routers are my anycast ASBR points. So while I don't see the full end-to-end path, I'm at least able to provide an ERO that traverses across the domains without any reachable information sent in these domains. So once, if you look at the path of the LSP here, you can see how it takes advantage of that. These segment IDs here, the 100-100, are anycast segments, and you can determine why, and you can show that they're anycast because you've got two ASBRs advertising these. So this segment 100-100 is advertised by 198-199 into this domain on the left. Similarly, this segment 200-200 is advertised by routers 221-223 into this domain here. None of these anycast prefixes are advertised into subsequent domains. So this is the whole ERO stack, and we also have the ability to specify a path across the domains without necessarily using any cast, where we can pick the best ASBRs. As in this LSP here, if I highlight this LSP quickly, you can see we've got basically the same type of LSP. However, in this case, it's choosing the best node set among the two possible options. And if you look at the ERO for this LSP, you can see that the first segment here is actually the segment ID for a node set for this router here, and the second is the segment ID for this router here. So the NSP computes an inter-domain path across multiple domains using specific options, as I've highlighted before. One is the loose hop anycast ASBRs and the fallback or the specification of loose hop ABRs. And stay tuned for more videos on the interdomain connection points.